Welcome to the SAP Business One Purchasing Process Overview Demo. The Purchasing AP Documents helps you run the purchasing process, starting with the purchase quotation and purchase order and continuing with the rest of the purchasing documents, including the receiving of the product, processing the invoice received from the vendor, capturing additional landed costs and outgoing payment. SAP Business One automatically captures information at each step so you always know what's on hand in inventory, as well as the up-to-the-minute financial state of your business. The real-time view helps you identify potential shortages before they happen. The purchasing process can start with a purchase request as an internal requisition, a purchase quotation to multiple vendors for bidding, or directly with a purchase order. We will focus on starting with a purchase order. To create a new purchase order, you can do so by going to the Purchasing AP module, Purchase Order. It is also possible to create a purchase order directly from a sales order if you are only buying on behalf of a customer and not purchasing for inventory. First, select the vendor. Next, select the item and the quantity that you need to buy. Note that the quantity column will automatically populate with the required quantity. This ensures that you have enough inventory to meet current demand of the item. The purchase price is automatically determined from the price list associated with the vendor, but can be changed. The Logistics tab of the purchase order advises the vendor where to ship the product. You have the option to deliver to the company level or to have the address taken from the warehouse on the purchase order. Add the purchase order to the system. This increases the ordered quantity of item. Like all other documents in SAP, you can email the purchase order directly to the vendor. Once the product arrives at the warehouse, the receiving team will be able to receive items directly from the purchase order by copying to a goods receipt purchase order. However, let us assume that we have multiple purchase orders that are being delivered at the same time. To simplify their process, the warehouse can open the goods receipt PO and copy from the multiple purchase orders. Only the open purchase orders and quantities will appear on this list. Select the lines that you are receiving. Update the quantity of what has been received. This will draw all the lines onto the receiving document. If the items are batch or serial managed, it can be optional or mandatory to capture the batch or serial number at time of receipt. If it is mandatory, SAP will prompt for the batch or serial numbers. If the warehouse is bin located, the system will automatically put it in the bin locations based on the receiving settings. If you are using receiving locations, SAP will put the inventory into the receiving bin locations. The warehouse team will execute a put-away process to put inventory in its final destination. Alternatively, the inventory is allocated directly to the final bin location by allocation rule or manual intervention. Once the GRPO is added to the system, it will increase the inventory levels as well as post the respective financial postings. The inventory GL accounts is debited and the goods received not yet invoiced account is credited. The impact on the inventory value is related to the valuation method of the item. For more information, please watch the video on inventory valuation methods. In the event that you noticed some products are damaged or don't pass your quality inspection, you can create a goods return request from the GRPO. This will initiate a return authorization from your vendor. You can save the RMA number from your vendor on the request in the vendor reference. Once the vendor confirms, you can copy the goods return request to a goods return. This will remove the inventory from SAP and send the product back to the vendor. If there are additional costs being incurred by receiving the products, like customs or insurance, it is possible to capture these expenses and embed it to the cost of the inventory by using a landed cost document. It is mandatory that the landed costs document be based on a goods receipt PO, AP invoice, or another landed cost. It is possible to set up and allocate the additional costs across the items based on value, quantity, volume, weight, or equally. The choice of how to split it depends on what the expense is. For example, if you have a high insurance bill because you have a very expensive product on the shipment, the majority of the cost should be allocated to the higher valued item. Alternatively, if you have an unusually expensive freight bill due to overweight items, you want to allocate the cost to the heavier items, that is the reason for the expense. Once you have indicated all the additional costs that need to be incurred, check to see how the allocation is applied to the items. Take note if any allocated costs seem unreasonable and make the necessary adjustments before posting the document. After you post the landed costs document, the price of the imported items is updated. And since it also contains all the costs that were allocated, the landed costs document creates a journal entry to reflect the additional import costs in accounting. If your final costs are not known yet, you can post landed costs as an estimate, and at a later stage post an adjusted landed cost document with the final numbers by copying the first landed cost document to a new one. Once the vendor provides you with the AP invoice for the goods, you can copy the goods receipt purchase order directly to the AP invoice and establish the invoice date. This will clear the goods received not invoice clearing account and post to the accounts payable for the vendor. Once the AP invoice is added, you can pay it directly from the document, or you can use the payment wizard to generate a check run or an electronic payment file to submit to the bank. For more details on this process, watch the video on banking process, payment wizard. We will simply pay this invoice via bank transfer. Select the bank account and the amount you wish to pay. Throughout the purchasing process, we have added many documents. The SAP relationship map can be viewed from any of the documents to see the complete flow of the documents, and allows an overview of where a particular order is within the process. There are many variations and iterations on the purchasing process, including upfront payments, down payments, unique return processes, assignment of serial numbers or batch numbers, and much more. To discuss your business requirements and how SAP Business One can improve your purchasing process, visit our website www.aclaros.com. We look forward to connecting.